sky was full of what looked like huge bats, all swooping and screeching and diving around the car. And a voice was screaming, holy Jesus, what are these goddamn animals?
Today, I'm going to teach you everything you need to know about mastering the art of gonzo journalism. And it's going to teach you how to be the most profane, most outrageous, most fucking spastic writer. Unlock all of those blocks that you've got on yourself and allow you to write freely, expanding your mind and just testing new connections. So stay tuned and you're going to learn exactly how to write like Hunter S. Thompson and go gonzo style on it, baby. Today we're going to learn how to break all of the rules as a writer. Smash those imposing beliefs that tell you that you're not allowed to write a certain way, or you have to format it like your teacher's grading you, or you've got to edit it like this, and write your prose in specific ways, because you don't. Hunter S. Thompson led the charge with this and created gonzo journalism. So today we're going to dive into gonzo journalism and I'm going to teach you how to do it. Pop a tab on your tongue, let that Lucy sink in, make sure you're feeling good, and get ready to go. Gonzo journalism is a style of journalism that features the author as the protagonist. He is simultaneously writing about and experiencing the story. It's an unconventional style of journalism that allows the writer to take part in the story and become the main character. While traditional reporting relies on hard facts, gonzo journalism allows the reader to step into the mind of the writer and understand the thoughts and feelings as the story takes place. It involves the use of sarcasm, humor, exaggeration, and in Hunter S.'s case, a lot of drugs.
We had 2 bags of grass, 75 pellets of mescaline, 5 sheets of high-powered blotter acid, a salt shaker half full of cocaine, a whole galaxy of multicolored uppers, downers, screamers, laughers, also a quarter tequila, quarter rum, case of beer, pint of raw ether, and 2 dozen amyls. Not that we needed all that for the trip, but once you get locked into a serious drug collection, the tendency is to push it as far as you can.
You don't have to do the drugs to be able to write like this. Sure, it helps. LSD is a quick ticket into that. It focuses a lot on the author's experiences and their personally held beliefs. And it provides a deeper message into the story through the use of satire and a lot of social critique. Whereas traditional journalism, well, we know what sort of shit show that's turned into. And that basically is supposed to depend on the facts. Whereas I'm not sure if it does or not, but hey, that's what they say they're supposed to do. CNN, NBC, Fox News. Don't know. It's up to you to decide. Gonzo journalism, however, well, there you can write whatever the fuck you want, really. And I love that. It is so freeing. You just pull out a piece of paper and write whatever you're experiencing, thinking, feeling, personal beliefs, exaggerating the fiction, and then incorporating the real autobiography into it. It's a unique type of writing which I've never come across before. Well, she's all you'd ever want. She's the kind I'd like to flaunt and take to dinner. So how did this mad genius that is Hunter S. Thompson come up with this brand new field of journalism? Well, to do that, we need to roll back the clock to the early 1970s when Hunter S. Thompson was enlisted in the US Air Force. There, he discovered he had a serious contempt for traditional journalism. He didn't like the fact that they were just speaking the facts and they weren't allowing the reader to come into the story through the writer's experiences. After he left the Air Force, Hunter S. Thompson decided to strap on a helmet, get on the back of a motorbike, and ride around with the notorious Hell's Angels Motorcycle Club. It was there that he started just documenting his journey. He carried a journal around with him and scribbled his thoughts and his opinions and his perspective on things while the chaos going on around him of being part of a motorcycle gang was surely leading into a story. At this time, he was due to produce an article for his editor, and he ended up just ripping pages out of his journal and sending it to him. Little did he know that would give rise to the gonzo journalism that we know today. The anarchy and mayhem that were preserved in the pages is exactly what gonzo journalism tries to encapture. It captures the raw essence of real events going on. He also wrote a piece about the Kentucky Derby called Kentucky Derby is Decadent and Depraved, which I highly suggest reading. I'll link it in the description because that shows you exactly what I'm talking about here with gonzo journalism. Now, let's take a trip to Vegas, where Hunter S. Thompson rose to fame. This is the notorious Fear and Loathing set, and what one could argue is the pinnacle of Hunter S. Thompson's career, the psychedelic masterpiece that is Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. This book had a profound impact on me, from the chaos and the drugs and the mayhem and the seemingly confusing plot that somehow made sense and gave rise to a different perspective on the social scene at the time and insights into Hunter S. Thompson's life. It was dramatic to read, to say the least. And if you're a stuck creator that wants to write more freely, I highly recommend picking up Fear and Loathing. Even watching the movie and trying to understand how it was written, there was something going on in Hunter's brain, obviously a caseload of drugs, probably enough to sedate a small island nation. But still, something amazing came out of it, and it is a wild journey through Las Vegas and America to find the American dream. And what did this wild ride of debauchery and chaos leave behind? A lasting impact on journalism and a change in how people were allowed to write. So now we're going to cover the four steps that I suggest if you want to write like Hunter S. Thompson and go Gonzo style on it. This is the best way to do so. First, embrace the madness. Unchain your mind and let the chaos rain down on the pages. Go out and live experiences and jot them down as you go. Exaggerate them, add hyperboles, go crazy, go on thought tangents that might be fiction, but also have a greater message throughout. Now, the only way that you can do this is just by testing. You go out and write stories and maybe add a little bit of spice to that real event that happened and just test your ability to write Gonzo style. Don't be afraid to let the emotions come into your pages and what your inner thoughts are really thinking, put them down. Now, I know this might seem scary to put onto paper in case someone reads it, or if you're trying to write a book and someone's gonna judge you for being inside your thoughts and emotions, but let that wash over you, because if you want to write Gonzo style, the main parts of it is thoughts and emotions of the protagonist. So what are you thinking? What are you feeling as these experiences are coming to you? And make sure you put that down on paper in a relatively logical way for the reader to understand. Second, you need to inject yourself into the narrative. There's no need for objectivity here. It is all subjective. It doesn't have to be factual. It is whatever the writer is experiencing. The Gonzo style requires that you are an integral part of the story. You have to be the main character, or at least the V character throughout the story, so that the reader can get your opinions and understand and almost experience the story through your eyes, your mind, your heart, and your feelings. Blur the lines between fact and fiction. No one really cares what really happened. If you're not writing for, say, a news outlet, if you're writing a fictional story, blur that. Like, take real events and turn it into something fantasy or something outrageous. Especially if you're trying to write something exciting and gripping for the reader, or something outside of the norms, just to break up what people normally read. Blur those lines so that the reader can't tell what is fact and what is fiction. That is where this Gonzo journalism style merges and creates something entirely unique. The third step is to unleash the fury of your language. You need to exaggerate words. You need to use powerful words that invoke a feeling into the reader. There should be an intense crackle and pop to the words and paint a vivid image in the reader's mind so that they can clearly understand what is going on in the story. They need to be able to picture exactly what is happening to you, and the best way to do that is with overly descriptive language, crazy words, hyperboles, unconventional metaphors that don't seem to go into place, but everyone knows what it is exactly talking about. Transport your reader into the story as if they are one of the characters themselves. Another key tip is not to be afraid of letting the reader into your thoughts. Tell them about your vices, your addictions, your downfalls, your regrets, what you're worried about or scared about. Be sure to let them ride shotgun on your journey through this book, because that is how they relate. And humans are flawed. All humans are, even the ones that act perfect. And there's something easier to connect to with the main character who is open about their flaws. And when the main character is the writer, something special happens. There is a direct link between the writer and the reader. And even reading Fear and Loathing after Hunter S. Thompson's dead, it's almost like you get a pathway into the man's brain and the way he lived that life. Whether it's fact or fiction, we don't know, but it makes for a great fucking story. So, as you go out to write, remember the immortal words of Hunter S. Thompson. Buy the ticket, take the ride. And if you have to, put a tab on your tongue, go for a walk, take your journal with you, and just write whatever the fuck your loosey brain comes up with. Because I promise you, that it is nothing like you could ever have expected. Embrace the madness, push the boundaries, get wild. Until next time, my friends, my lovelies, write like Hunter. Good luck.
No explanation, no mix of words or music or memories can touch that sense of knowing that you were there and alive in that corner of time in the world. whatever it meant.